Well, of course, there was the lovely case of the rear gunner in one of the big bombers, and he got over the target, or perhaps he was short of the target, and he said excitedly, "Skip, skip, they're firing at us." And the pilot said in a tired voice, "I know, they're allowed to." You know, which was lovely, laconic reply. But, I mean, on one occasion, this occasion when I got everything wrong, I thought, well, I wonder if I'm frightened. I certainly was embarrassed, but was I frightened? And I thought, wait a second, let's see. So I went like that. And I thought, no, that's steady. That's not shaking. And I took my, well, no, that's not pumping fast. And then I could feel a same line of sweat along my upper lip. And I thought, ah, that's what fear smells like. But, you know, I strongly suspect that I was scared of Doug, not of the Germans. Certainly I had reason. He didn't pull any punches.
But weren't you both terrified? I mean, you know, you, at any moment you could be blown out of the sky, I suppose.
No, you weren't. You were busy. Absolute. You were in your bubble. You were utterly concentrated. There's no room for fear. The body doesn't take two emotional messages at a time, I don't think. You know. I'm pretty certain that fear was not one of my problems. And then, of course, there was the other time that my little G set, which was a lovely little thing, which had all sorts of patterns going across it, it blew a fuse. Well, there's something wrong with it, I don't know. So I put in another fuse, which is a little kind of cartridge like that. It blew that too. So I put in another, it blew that too. So I put in a penny, as I'd been taught, down in the basement. Well, it couldn't blow the penny, so it set fire to the thing. So I'd got, just by my left ear, I'd got quite a merry little bonfire going. And I beat it out with my bare hands, and Doug was furious, you know, not speaking, just a mouth, a grim line. Next day I was mentioned in dispatches for heroism and initiative in refusing to give in to whatever. I thought, oh, they've all gone mad. The world's gone bonkers.